Well, hello friends, it's Amy Ferlici at the Gathering Inspiration Stamp Studio, and today I have another fun card to share with you. So this is a really simple layout. This is one, a layout that I've used for a long time, like through the years. I love, so I used a couple of strips of washi tape and then a strip of designer series paper. A lot of times I might even use all three strips of washi tape, and I did try that. I'm going to show you. These are the super cute. This is the, I think it's called the Follow Your Art washi tape. And I will confirm that. I will include the item codes and details for everything that we're using on the video in the details to the YouTube video. So check that out. But I loved, so these are the three different patterns of washi tape that come in the Follow Your Art washi tape. And I loved, you see the super cute one. We've got some little teeny tiny Stampin'Up boxes, and then they gave us washi tape to kind of, you know, use as like packing tape. And I tried to actually use, I think I kind of did maybe about like that is what I did. I ran all three of them on my card, and I just, it wasn't working for me. So I literally found my designer series paper, my Follow Your Art designer series paper, and covered up. If you peek behind that little strip right there, you will see the washi tape is still underneath there. So anyway, and that's how it goes, right? Sometimes the designing of a card doesn't always work quite the way you intend for it to, but that's okay because you end up with a great result at the end of it all. So my point is, you could use three strips of washi tape there, you could use three strips of designer series paper, or you could use some version of, like I did here, we've got a couple of strips of washi tape and a piece of designer series paper. And then that super cute stamp, that Do Something Creative Every Day. I love this stamp set. And I also love that I can pull product that I've had for a while. So for example, this Crafting Forever stamp set with that Do Something Creative Every Day stamp. Some other great sentiments on here. This one, the fun little, it says made with love right there. And then you've got the Crafting Forever, Housework Whenever, and We Are Cut Out to Be Friends, with of course some scissors and then some other fun kind of crafting imagery. So this is a stamp set that we have had for quite a while, and I love to do that. I love to pull out something that I've had for a while and then incorporate it with some of our new products. And I have to show you guys, I made these samplers for all of our designer series paper in the annual catalog. So you can see this is the Follow Your Art designer series paper. And so I just kind of picked up this whole palette. I've got front and back of every piece of designer series paper in that Follow Your Art DSP pack. So front and back of each of these. So for example, if you say, oh, I don't know if I like that pattern, well, this is what's on the other side. So as long as you like that one, you're going to be fine. You run into more of the trouble when you're like, ooh, I love both of those. Which side am I going to use, right? That happens to me more than not. And then I love this also, including, these are just little 1-inch circles that tell me all of the solid colored cardstock that coordinate with the colors in our designer series paper. That is probably one of the most fabulous things that Stampin' Up! Does for us, is gives us that great color coordination with our cardstock and then the colors in the designer series paper. And then I made my little list right down here too. So oops, let's see if you can see, the Follow Your Art designer series paper coordinates with Basic Gray, Blushing Bride, Calypso Coral, Coastal Cabana, Crushed Curry, Pacific Point, and Whisper White cardstock. And those are what are all kind of included right there. So great kind of quick flash of all of that awesome Follow Your Art designer series paper too. I love this paper. Anybody who's into crafting is going to love this paper also. So, okay, let's go ahead and get started. So like I said, super simple layout here. We are gonna actually move these pieces out of the way. Let's do our stamping and die cutting first, and then we'll kind of put our card together. So I have, this is just a scrap piece of Whisper White cardstock. I have my Coastal Cabana ink pad. I'm just gonna pop that open. And then we've got our Do Something Creative Every Day stamp. We're just gonna, that was a nice easy tap, 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 upside down, but no big deal because I am gonna run that through the Big Shot. So that didn't really matter whether I did it the right way or the wrong way. Okay, I'm gonna grab the Big Shot. And we're gonna set that baby right there so you guys can see what we're doing. I'm using the layering circle framelits. Those are the dies that I use, layering circle dies. And I'm gonna pop these right in here. I will tell you, this is the third smallest straight edge circle, and then the scallop circle is the fourth smallest, if that makes sense, hopefully, in those packages. So we're just gonna pop. So I've got my magnetic platform, one clear cutting pad, then my paper and my dies, and then my other clear cutting pad on top. Always put the ridge down to make your cut. Okay, and see how nice and easy those pop right out. I'm gonna scoot our big shot out of the way. Okay, so now we have, I'll give you some dimensions too. We have a Coastal Cabana, let me make sure, is that in view? Yep, Coastal Cabana card base. Let's get that straightened out a little bit for you. Okay, so we've got our cardstock that measures 8.5 by 11. Along the 11 inch side, I cut it in half at 5.5 inches. And then over here along the 8.5 inch side, I scored it at 4.25 inches. Okay, we'll do that, fold along our score mark for a nice crisp fold on our card. Then we have a piece of Whisper White cardstock. This is a good layering size. I do this all the time. So 4 inches by 5.25 inches is what kind of gives just that little peak of Coastal Cabana cardstock around the edge there. Okay, so now I'm gonna grab the fun washi tape and we're gonna start. And you will notice, if you can see very, can we get close enough? The pattern on this washi tape is very similar, and it might even be easier to see, to the pattern on that piece of designer series paper there. So that's the fun thing too, is that we can use our washi tape and we can use our designer series paper all together. I just kind of peel off a little bit there. I like to kind of rip at a little angle there. So I am going to kind of lay that down maybe. Oops, right about that kind of went crazy on me there. And there you can see that, the print on the washi tape a little bit better. Just rip that off and then I'm gonna tuck it right behind there. And I like to press firmly to make sure I've done a good job of adhering that. And then we have to just kind of scroll around here till we find, okay, how many times do we have to scroll around? It's like I can almost feel it. Maybe I'm going the wrong way. That's why, because I was going the wrong way. Okay, so again, I want to kind of rip that so that I like how that's going to look on this side. And I'm going to just lay that piece down. And this washi tape, as long as you don't stick it too firmly, you could pull it up and reposition it. Once I do that, it's a little bit more difficult to kind of reposition that. And then I'm just gonna, you see, I've just kind of got those tucked back behind there, okay? So I'm gonna show you that a little bit closer up because it gets a little bit covered up when I put the rest of it on there. But those are a couple of strips of that fun washi tape. And then like I said, this super cute, the Stampin' Up. Can you see the cute little Stampin' Up logo? Washi tape also. We're gonna have to find some fun project for that washi tape. Okay, now this little piece of designer series paper is part of that Follow Your Art designer series paper, and it measures, I'm gonna get that off of there. We have a 3 quarters of an inch by 5 inch piece of designer series paper. And I am just gonna kinda rip along the edges. I just like to see that little bit of rip there also. And then we're gonna just go that one like that. So that's all, can you kind of see? I like to see that kind of frayed edge sometimes on my designer series paper, kind of when I rip things. I don't rip my paper very much anymore. I used to do that a lot more. So I'm gonna have to remember that. That's kind of a fun thing to do. And we're just gonna lay this guy down right about there. Then I will tell you I cheated because I didn't have any. So if you'll notice back on my little kind of grid paper here with all the designer series paper, the kind of orange color I'm going to say that coordinates is Calypso Coral. But I didn't have any Calypso Coral ribbon. So I grabbed, this is my Grapefruit Grove ribbon. And I think because that is so kind of a pale washed Calypso Coral, I think you can get away with it. So that's what I did. So occasionally you can kind of bend your colors a little bit in the color spectrum there. So what I did was I just cut a strip of, again, this is my Grapefruit Grove. This is an 1/8 inch Grosgrain ribbon. And I found it was easiest to just put this strip around here like this. We're gonna just tack this on the back. You wanna use a good amount of adhesive to make sure that sticks on the back of your card. And I always like to flip this over because sometimes I'm afraid I'm gonna end up with the ribbon kind of going sideways. So if I flip it over, I can make sure that I've got going straight across. And then again, I'm gonna push really firmly I'm gonna add some more adhesive. Oops, let's scoot those skizzers out of the way a little bit. Scissors, skizzers, you know. Okay, so we added our adhesive. We are gonna just put this white, whisper white piece of cardstock down on there. We're gonna press firmly. Then I am gonna just tie a little bow separately, and oops, I forgot my glue dots. So normally after I make this bow here, I would pop this on with a glue dot. For video purposes only, we're just gonna use a little bit of snail, and then I'll fix that after we're done with the video. You really wanna use glue dots to adhere this little bow. So I'm gonna just put that little bow right about there. So I'm just gonna add a little bit of my snail adhesive. Again, I would normally put a glue dot behind there to make sure that stays on. It's gonna be fine for now, but I'll fix that later for us. Okay, then I've got my little scallop circle and my Do Something Creative Every Day. Super cute. I'm actually making these cards and sending them to my top five in sales in my downline, in my Inkspired Stampers group. So hopefully they will have gotten their cards before they actually see this video. You never know. Might be a little spoiler alert here too. I love to do that though. Every month I send cards to my top five in my downline to say congratulations and great job, ladies. It's fun to recognize people for their efforts, I believe. Plus, who doesn't love another cute handmade card in the mail, right? So one last step, I have my Happiness Blooms enamel dots. So in keeping with me using my Grapefruit Grove color, I pulled the Grapefruit Grove little enamel dots off of here. So I am just going to grab and pop a couple of these little babies. We're gonna put one there and then one teeny tiny, maybe one right about there. And that is it. So simple, cute, cute card. Love this idea though, with the layout with either the washi tape or designer series paper. You can make this card with just about every single pack of designer series paper that we have. If we had more washi tape, you could do more fun things with the washi tape too. So anyway, that's all we have for today, is this one little pack of washi tape. Oh, but actually there is some other fun, beautiful flower petal washi tape, which I do not have yet. So sorry, I'm getting way off tangent, but I was just thinking, ooh, we do have a little bit of washi tape. Not as much as I would like though, because I love that simple layout for us. So thank you guys for watching today. I hope you were inspired today. If you are so inclined, you can check out other fun projects on my blog at gatheringinspiration.com. You're also gonna wanna grab the host code from my blog. It's on that right-hand side toolbar so that when you're ready to shop and get some of the products that we used on this card, use that host code. You are always entered into a drawing that I do on Facebook Lives every Friday when you order at least $30 from me. You always get the projects I demonstrate on Facebook Live, and you always get a free embellishment if you bump your order up to over $50. So lots and lots of good stuff as my thank you. If you do not have a demonstrator, I would love to be your demonstrator. If you need a catalog, let me know. I'm happy to answer any questions that you guys have. If you want to know anything more about this card or anything else I have going on. So thanks so much for watching today, guys. Bye, everybody. Have a great day. We'll see you soon.